I'm Simon Whitfield, four-time Olympian, two-time Olympic medalist, and proud flag bearer at the 2012 Olympic Games. I was asked to write a poem by AthletesCAN on the poetry of sport. Wonderful Vanessa Smythe came along and helped me, and we came up with The Torch We Carry. And what is The Torch We Carry? It's that drive that we all have to keep moving, to keep walking, to working common enterprise with others. And sport is a venue, an arena, this theater that we get to express that in and express ourselves and express these gifts that we have and express the work that we put in and find the best of ourselves and see our greatest flaws. And I hope Vanessa and I were able to convey that in The Torch We Carry. It was a privilege to be part of.
If I only had one more chance to run, swim, pedal, one more chance to burn the fuel inside me, I'd take my mark and ready my body to unleash all it has inside.
My mind would quiet the thoughts that seek the spotlight. My breath, nothing else, is the one that utters go.
At the sound of the gun, I'd move with the gift I'd be given, one I've spent my lifetime trying to earn.
And me and the others who also believe what's inside them, we'd run and we'd fire with every single thing we have. The wind in our face, roar of the crowd, our breath in our legs, in our arms, in our lungs.
And though this moment would be special, it wouldn't capture all the moments that came before it, wouldn't replace or erase a single one.
Like the time I was first to cross the line, and I got the gaze of my dad shining bright.
Or the time I failed my own expectations, couldn't hurdle what was in front of me.
The times that I caved, fell, broke, and it took everything I had not to run and jump the fence.
La fois où on m'a dit que j'étais dépassée, finie, mais que je me suis promis que cet amour que je sentais, que ce feu, même s'il avait faibli, brûlait toujours en moi.
So that when I went back and won victory again, I knew I'd kept this promise to myself.
For this all started when I was young and small, when we were kids on playscapes who ran until our bones hurt.
And leapt like we had wings, for we wanted to be just like our heroes.
Our heroes showed us strength, practice, patience, grace, getting hurt, getting up.
We'd watch and wonder, lean in close, hover around the radio and cram into stadiums, and gather in fallen snow beneath a big screen that showed our red and white.
We saw what any of us could be, what any of us could stumble through, and what any of us could fail at or succeed.
These heroes of ours went into the darkness and left all they had behind them. In this, they gave us their gifts and lived for us their lessons.
We'd scream at our televisions, shout with our families with anger and passion and joy. And in those moments, the running narratives in our head would stop running.
It'd be quiet, just these humans fighting with everything they have for life, for a moment to stand highest.
In that deep sense of now, before the lights came back on and we no longer heard the chorus in our head, our hearts knew their place, and our bodies felt connected to their kind.
So we learned to go to sleep that hour sooner, rise before the crack of dawn, pull up, push up, condition, train, not quit.
And in our striving to be like the ones we believed in, we endured and remained when our bodies and hearts got broken, always remembering what our heroes imparted.
Live fiercely, but tread lightly. Never clutch the baton or the torch too tightly, for these are only borrowed moments.
And just as the ones before us rose and faded, so too will we, into the sweet stillness of age and time fade, and slowly walk with our children's children. May we be so lucky.
So let us, as we walk, while the fire has lit the torch we carry, and as we glance behind us and see the faces, the millions of eyes and glowing hearts beating strong,
rappelons-nous le privilège que nous avons d'être en vie et d'être ensemble jour et nuit à titre de messager de notre devenir.
For when we push ourselves through barriers and walls, we might all feel the collapse of divisions and space between us.
And even if the world is sad and broken, if people are angry or misunderstood, perhaps we can quietly learn from our ancestors of sport.
That our bodies need to run, our voices need to sing, our fists need to pound, and our hearts need to beat a little faster for something to believe in.
For nowadays, though my laces aren't as tight, and I no longer run to stand the tallest ground,
I feel that same heat when I look at my children and see their magnificence and wonder. And as I look down at my hands that are empty and uncertain of what to do, I can only hope that in me somewhere is that same guidance, that same breath that says, steady now,